It was another listless trading day for the local stock market on Thursday. The rest of Asia also trading cautiously after Wall Street fell from record levels due to a mixed bag of earnings. After wavering between gains and losses, the local market saw a last-minute kick to close up 0.6%, settling just a tad below the 7,900 level.
Well, right now, our index is stuck inside a consolidation, and so far what we've seen in the last 2 days, it's managed to bounce from an area quite close to support. So far, so good. However, I'd feel more comfortable if the index can push over 8,000. We do have support in the index closer to 7,724, and if we do get a rupture of that, then the 7,6, which was the previous low that we saw back in the beginning of March, were more likely to be the next target. This is going to be a stock picker's market. This is not going to be a very broad movement. We've seen some people cut our growth rates, and that would mean that you're not going to see very broad movement.
In the earnings stream, BPI, the country's fourth largest bank by assets, posted a single-digit growth in the first quarter of the year. Net income rose 8% to 6.3 billion pesos as revenue jumped 24% to nearly 24 billion. The big jump was driven by a strong 29% increase in net interest income. The bank enjoyed better margins last year when the Philippine Central Bank raised key policy rates by 175 basis points. This is the second big bank to report. BDO had fired the opening salvo, hitting nearly 10 billion pesos in profit in the first 3 months of the year thanks to strong trading and foreign exchange gains.
We think they will be very supportive of where the market is and where it should be headed, which is north. Go long. This is our message today, and I think you know, we're going to see this market head towards a 9,000 level and beyond. And you know, we think not right away, maybe this year, maybe early next year.
Speaking of the Ayala Group, the merger of its education arm, AC Education, with the Yuchenko-led iPeople has gotten the nod of the Securities and Exchange Commission and will take effect by May 2. The merger involves an exchange of shares between iPeople and AC Education, with iPeople being the surviving entity valued at 15.5 billion pesos. Its parent, House of Investments, will control 51.3% and the Ayala Group 33.5%. The merger will bring together seven educational institutions of iPeople, including the Mapua Institute of Technology and AC Education, with campuses in Metro Manila, Calabarzon, Bicol, and Mindanao. And ABS-CBN diversifying into cosmetics, e-payments, and food as revenues from traditional sources, ads, get squeezed. ABS-CBN is partnering with Everbilena 50-50 to manufacture, trade, and sell cosmetics. The joint venture will have an authorized capital stock of 10 million pesos. Meanwhile, ABS-CBN is also getting into a joint venture with iBuyit Online Ventures to provide Filipinos with e-wallet and an e-money services. ABS-CBN will own 51%, iBuyit 49% of the joint venture, with an authorized capital stock of 100 million pesos. Food is also in the company's radar. ABS-CBN is investing in a wholly owned subsidiary, The Chosen Bun, which will establish and operate restaurants, coffee shops, and refreshments parlors. The company will have an authorized capital stock of 1 million pesos. Finally, Cebu Pacific confirms a breach in its GetGo application server Wednesday night. It assures the public credit card information of clients are not stored on that particular server. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.